I'm Johan. Today I'm going to talk briefly about Palantir's decomposition interview. You're going to face this interview type across most engineering roles that Palantir looks for. Although this round initially used to come up primarily in FDSE roles, by the end of this video, you should have a good understanding of what this round is all about and some guidance from us on how to approach it. Last but not least, we'll include a sample question reported by a recent Palantir candidate to give you an idea of what you'll encounter. Quick intro, I'm from Prepfully. This overview has been put together by Palantir engineers who are also interview coaches on Prepfully, the very same ones who have helped hundreds of candidates with mock interviews and advice. This video is just one out of a range of content we've developed. We'll link the other stuff in the description below. You can always book time with the coaches directly for a more personalized guidance on Prepfully's website. Right, on to the overview. So the decomposition round of the Palantir SWE interview process is all about breaking down complicated and ambiguous questions. It's a high-level system design question where you're given a problem or data points and asked to design a solution by breaking it down and creating a plan for implementation. The key thing to remember is that it's an open-ended problem, so it's important to think about the user and communicate your thought process clearly throughout the interview. Here's our recommended approach to handling this interview type. We recommend breaking it down into 5 steps. Step 1. Understand the problem. You should be very clear about what you're trying to solve for and how the data points you're provided could be leveraged as a part of your solution. Make sure you understand the problem or data points that you are given. Asking clarifications is both important and expected. Think of constraints, scenarios, scale, amongst others. Step 2. Break the problem down into smaller, manageable pieces. Start with the user, move on to their needs or how they access the system before moving into the different layers involved in architecting your solution. Go broad and then go deep. And what I mean specifically is to run through the whole system before digging deeper into specific aspects. Which brings me on to step 3. Communicate your thought process. Keep checking in with your interviewer. Ask them if they'd like you to go down a certain path. Your interviewer is trying to assess you across a range of things, so it's important to give them the room to say something like, "All right, let's talk about this more," or alternatively, "Right, let's move on." These are just examples. Step 4 then. Think of real-world scenarios. Scale is an obvious one. The data sets you're going to be working with will nearly always have tremendous scale, so your systems need to be able to bear that. You should be able to discuss the pros and cons and make trade-offs. You should also think of other real-world edge cases, such as how you'd handle missing or inaccurate data or sparse data and so on. Final step then, and there's no real replacement for this, is to practice. Try to practice with sample questions or similar problems to get a feel for what the interview might be like. Try to practice with engineers who've been through the Palantir process before, or best of all, practice with a Palantir engineer who knows what the process looks like and can give you targeted, specific feedback on how you're doing in this round. Right then, here's the promised question that a candidate reported. You are given 8,000 records of taxi data in London with 8 different columns. ID, fare, start location, end location, start time, end time, and distance. You need to suggest an idea, draw system components, come up with required API and code if required for a solution that can be developed and deployed in 1 week. What would you do? As we mentioned before, the key here is to methodically break down this question into step-by-step, smaller pieces and think about what kind of solution would be beneficial for the taxi drivers, what system components would be needed, and what APIs would be required. And remember, communicate your thought process clearly to the interviewer. Hope that helped. Once you feel ready for some practice or just want a sense check on your preparation level for the Palantir Decomp interview, you can anonymously book a mock interview with a Palantir software engineer on Prepfully. We've included a link in the description below. In addition, I've linked to a bunch of useful resources in the description, most of which are free. There's a written guide, there are several interview questions. If you have a follow-up question or you want to know more about the interview, ask in the comments. And if you found this video useful, don't forget to like and subscribe. Thanks and good luck.
Thanks for watching the video. If you liked it, please subscribe. Our website is prepfully.com. We've got lots of interview questions there. You can also schedule a mock interview with one of our experts. You can find the link in the description below. All the best from us at Prepfully, and we hope you totally rock your interview.